Hey guys, Appalachian Knife Reviews back with a new video for you guys today. I wanted to come up with a little challenge for myself, and I wanted to see if I could find five knives under $20 that would be decent knives, maybe something I recommend, something I don't. We'll see. So I maybe cheated a little bit in this video because some of these knives were marked down to $20, but normally they were more expensive. So as of the time of me purchasing these knives, all five of these were under $20. They all come from Amazon. I'll have links down in the descriptions if you want to pick one up. I can't remember exactly which ones were which, but some of them were marked like 30% off, 50% off. I think two of them. The rest of them all normally are under $20, but I think two of them were marked down. But these are five knives I picked up for less than $20, and let's get into it. So we're going to start up here with this one. See if I can get to zoom in here. Well, if you've watched my channel at all, you see I have done videos with these knives. These are Sativia knives. This is a big chunky boy. Now, what we're going to do is I'll show you all of them first, and then once we get the boxes cleared out of the way, I'll show you the scales, the measurements, and all that stuff. So this is a front flipping knife with a monster blade on it. What if we get the zoom in there? So it's Aus 10 steel. Sativian makes fantastic knives. I was thinking this was D2, but it's not. It's that Aus 8 steel. But I think Sativian, for the money, it shocks me how well these knives are made for the price that you can get them for. I'm not real good normally with, if you've watched my videos long enough, you've probably laughed at me watching me trying to do a front flipper. This thing is actually really, really easy to front flip. Maybe one of the easiest knives I've ever used. So we'll set that one aside for a second. Now, when I was doing this challenge, when I was on Amazon shopping, the Flissa knives come up more and more and more. They seem to be about the cheapest knives that you can find. I noticed they do have one that looks similar to the Bug Out. Let you see this one. This is the, it doesn't really have a name on it. 4.25 inches, black G10 handle folding knife with lock. So this is an crossbar lock, access lock, call it what you want. I'm not real good at flipping these. If it doesn't have a flipper tab, or at least I can, my hands are so big and awkward, I can't really flip it real well. So see, if that's an issue for you, you may want to consider not picking up this knife. Now, as far as using the crossbar lock, it flips out fantastic. Now, one of the things that I've said before in previous videos, how a knife closes kind of tells me, I don't want to say how cheap, obviously these are cheap knives under $20, but I don't like when it bounces when I close it. So when I go to close that knife, if it bounces, I don't like it. I have some other Flissa knives that seem to be pretty fantastic knives. D2 steel. So there's that one. The next one is, oh, Efengrow. Okay, so this is a knife from Efengrow. Now, all these knives being under $20, they got a little bit of quirks. So this one, it flips pretty easy. It's, you know, it's a liner lock. I can't flip it with the tab out there. I don't know if maybe you guys can, but I cannot flip it with that thumb stud. Maybe it's not meant to. But again, I think it's a beautiful looking knife. I'm not real big on these. Those kind of tabs. I'm just, aesthetically, I just don't like them. D2 steel. Tip down carry. I really, really like the way this knife looks. I have a couple other Efengrows. No, actually, this is my second Efengrow. And I think they, again, like Sativian, I think they make really good knives for the money. And again, I think it's a really, really pretty knife. Now, this one is a Gonzo. Now, if it means anything to anybody, this one is actually boxed better than the others. The others just had like a little goofy black box. There is the Gonzo model. Now this one comes with a little Gonzo carrying bag. Now again, this is another one of those where it looks like a really, really good knife. Flips fine. The Omega spring in this thing is really, really tight. Now I know you guys have told me on previous videos that you can get in there and adjust these. I just have never personally done it because most of the knives I buy, I don't have any issues with them. But it's a fantastic looking knife. Now I know we're not going into a whole lot of details on the knives. I'll see if we can get this to focus here. 440C. See, it flips fine. It's just that spring is really tight. And then the last one's kind of a little bit cheating, I think, because it's a knife, but it's a razor blade. So let me show you. Let me open this one up. And I kind of picked, I chose this one, one, because the price, because it was the $20 knife challenge. We've already done, this is the best $10 knife you can get, I think. And this one I wanted because I have several of these outdoor edge knives with the replaceable razor blade. And I had never seen one. I'm trying to get the other blades out so I can show you everything in full effect. There we go. Okay. So these have a replaceable razor blade. This one, I believe, you're pushing the button there. I don't want to cut myself. Is that how you fold a knife? I don't know. It's a back push. Okay. Duh. I'm being goofy here. So this one, you push down the button. All right, give me a second, guys. Let me figure out how to do this one. This one's different than my other one. Okay, it's exactly what I thought it was. It was just being kind of, I guess it was stiff. You push the little button in. Well, watch me not be able to do it now on camera. Push the button in, and it pulls out. So this comes in handy for me when I'm doing stuff like field dressing a deer. If the blade gets dull, basically I can just swap it out. It comes with an extra blade. And this is the first time I've had the mini. So the other ones that I have are like a full size. They're like a, you know, like a 3-inch blade, 2-inch blade. So there, that is what we are looking at, guys. 5 blades, under $20. Now I told you, we'll show you the measurements here. Let me set these off to the side. We're gonna do weights first. So this is in ounces. So the Gonzo knife is 4.526. The Ethan-Grow is 3.6. The Flissa is also 3.6. That chunky boy is 6. Hold on. Let me flip this over. 6.3 ounces. And then obviously this one is pretty tiny. So 1.4. And then I'm going to get out the ruler and show you guys their measurements. So that one's, well, if you go from that tip out there, you're looking almost 5 inches. Your overall is about 8 inches with about a 2.5-inch blade. And I'm going to tell you guys, this is my favorite of the bunch. I like the blade shape. I like how easy the front flipper is. So this is my pick. This is probably number one. This one's probably number two, three, and four. I'm not really ranking this one with these because this one, I mean, it could be one or five. It doesn't matter because it serves a different purpose. So probably one, two, three, four is probably how I would rank these. About four and a half. Your overall is a little over eight with about a 3 1/4 inch blade. That one's almost 4.5. Overall is about 8 with about a 3 1/4 inch blade. Again, about 4 inches. Overall 7 with like a 2 3/4 inch blade. And then this last little nugget here, this thing is tiny. It's much smaller than I thought it was going to be. It's like 2 3/4. Got a 2 inch blade and overall of about 5 inches. I hope this video helps you guys in some way today. If it does help you, or if it's something you appreciate or something you like, make sure you hit that like button. If you have not done so yet, it really does help the channel if you hit the subscribe button. And all of these knives will be linked down in the description. My links tend to be affiliate links. They do help the channel. I do make a small commission off of them when you buy one, or use, you know, when you buy something from my links. And then I turn right around and do stuff like buy more knives to make more videos for you guys. So if that's something you want to do, hit up my affiliate links, pick up something. It helps the channel grow. I appreciate every one of you for watching the videos and taking the time to comment and click those links. And hope to see you guys in the next one.